How goes the family? How goes it? Hopefully you guys are having a great day. I didn't think I was gonna speak on this specific matter, but I think I need to give my two cents, and especially since it's all around social media. And it's regarding this young lady who's an Olympic sprinter, Sha'Carri Richardson. So I'm gonna put my two cents into this, and I'm just gonna leave it at this because it's my opinion. Everybody's entitled to their opinion. Look, everybody makes mistakes in this life. No one's disputing that. But at the end of the day, this is a hard lesson for this young lady. Great, talented sprinter, Olympic. Had a chance to compete in the Olympics, and now that chance is gone because she tested positive for marijuana. Now, here's my take on the situation. It's unfortunate, but I'm happy that she got basically disqualified from competing because she broke the rules. Regardless of what you might think about the whole marijuana thing, I don't have a real opinion on it. My mindset is, especially if adults are having a conversation about marijuana, it better be because they're investing in it in the stock market, or it's because they're opening up their own dispensary, or because they have their own brand. Outside of that, as an adult, having that conversation outside of what I just said, I think it's a complete waste of time. I'm not a marijuana advocate on any level. And I know more and more states are legalizing it. I mean, heck, even my home state of Virginia has legalized it and whatnot, I believe, to a point, and I think it's going to progress in years to come. But as adults, young people are going to do stupid things. We all, people, you grow, you learn, all that good stuff. But adults having conversations and binging about being able to get high and all that, I find that to be kind of idiotic and to be a complete waste of time. People that are, binge smoking weed and just playing games or watching TV and listening to music and eating and drinking, and that's all you do with your life, then that's you just trans as an especially as a working adult, translates to loser. I say this is because of this specific reason. There's so many opportunities that have been missed because people want to get high and get drunk. People have lost their livelihoods because they got a DUI. They've unfortunately killed somebody or hurt somebody because they were drinking and driving. A lot of people that smoke marijuana and whatnot, they miss a lot of great opportunities in this life, especially from a sports perspective. Okay, now me, I'm not a sports guy, but I know one thing that in order for you to be successful in any sport, you have to have success. You have to have some sort of discipline. That's why a lot of people that are Olympians, or a lot of people that are in professional sports like the NBA, NFL, they are great, some of the greatest entrepreneurs on the planet and great investors on the planet for one specific reason. It's because they have discipline. They have a lot of discipline when it boils down to what they do, and they just apply that same discipline into finance. They apply that same discipline into business. And that's how they're able to be successful and do a lot of specific things in this life and grow. I mean, Shaquille O'Neal is a great example of a disciplined person. Okay, I think Shaquille O'Neal has almost 30 businesses. Was once known as a basketball playing mogul. Now he's known as a business mogul. Believe he's got two master's degrees and is a part-time police officer, or U.S. Marshal, or something to that effect. Because the man was disciplined. Okay, when you lack discipline, there are consequences in this life. I don't care how you feel about marijuana and whatnot. Like, a lot of people have lost great opportunities to join the military, to join law enforcement organizations, to join hospital organizations, to work for hospital organizations, to compete in sports, to be on faculties. I mean CDL drivers. I the list goes on and on because doing this is more important than getting this. That's a problem. That's my mindset, okay? She made a mistake. She's going to learn her lesson. Sha'Carri Richardson, this isn't a bashing on her or anything of that nature. This is when you there's consequences, okay? Because for the in my because this is my whole thing. There's consequences to what you do in this life or what you don't do in this life. Like, if you don't pay your bills, you're going to get kicked out and have things turned off. If you don't pay your rent and mortgage, you have a chance of losing your place and things of that nature. If you don't pay your cell phone bill, kiss social media goodbye. So if the rules are set in place, if you are an Olympic in a position to be an Olympic athlete, you know that there's a chance that you're going to get a urinalysis test done. And she knew walking in the door once that urinalysis test was going to go in. I guess she thought she was going to be able to do something to try to finagle away and all that good stuff. But she knew that the chances were probably, if she didn't know, she knows now, the chances were higher for her to get caught up or whatnot. When you lack discipline, things like this happen. It's like when you lack discipline when you come to your finances. When you lack discipline in what you drink, what you eat, there's consequences. There's a lot of consequences to when people are live very unhealthy lifestyles. There's big, big consequences in regards to that. There's consequences when you sleep with a bunch of people. You have a bunch of babies all over the place and whatnot. You could catch a disease and whatnot. Lack of discipline can get people in so much trouble nowadays. It could end them up in the jail cell, or it could end them up in a freaking graveyard. Okay? Or it could take half their finances away because they lack the discipline to control their sexual appetite, things of that nature. So that's why the word discipline, I wish I was doing the word of the day discipline, because that's what was missing here, and that's what's missing with a lot of people. And then they wonder why things don't work out in the specific ways that they want it to. It's because they lack the specific discipline. The discipline to do specific things, the discipline to read and listen to specific things. There's a lot of lack of discipline. And a lot of people during the pandemic, they had a lot more time on their hands. Some people had discipline to get in better shape, to get their intelligence on point, to learn a new skill, to start a business, to get a better job. And then you had other people that were wondering what they could watch on Netflix. I'm just saying. So in this situation, she lacked the discipline to not smoke marijuana. And I heard that unfortunately her mother passed away, and and she's going through the grieving process. And I know when you lose somebody that's close to you, especially your parent, it's never easy. Okay, I didn't grow up with my father and whatnot. And a lot of times people will use an excuse, well, I didn't have both parents, so therefore that's an excuse for me to act out and do what I do. And it's just not at the end of the day, especially when you had a chance to make history for yourself. And it's like I said, to me, it's unfortunate. It really is, because a lot of people have, and I'm gonna end it on this note. Talent means nothing without discipline. So if you're a talented singer, it means nothing if you don't have the discipline. If you're a talented actor or actress, it means nothing without discipline. If you're a talented athlete, it means nothing without discipline. Okay, if you're talented in whatever you do in this life, whether you're an IT specialist, whether you have a CDL, whether you're a mechanic, an electrician, an engineer, it means nothing without discipline. That's why institutions require people to have a certification in something or a degree in something, because then it shows you have discipline and focus in order for you to pass certain amount of tests and write a certain amount of reports, do a certain amount of presentations and things of that nature. That's why when the people that get promoted in certain organizations, they have the discipline and they're all about their job, and they're oriented, they're mission oriented in regards to getting our specific jobs done. And that's why entrepreneurs are rewarded, because they're disciplined in regards to selling their product, marketing, connecting with the right people. There's If you don't have discipline, you're not gonna make it in this world. Okay? Because a lot of people will be like, well, Snoop Dogg made it and he's a weed smoker. Well, hey, here's the difference between Snoop Dogg and Sha'Carri Richardson. Snoop Dogg has his own weed dispensaries. Snoop Dogg has his own freaking marijuana brands, okay? Do I agree with him smoking weed? No. But at least my man can put his money up with what when he does this. That's all I got to say. So when you're an owner of something, you got a lot more leeway. When you own something, it gives you a lot more leeway to control something. Okay? Then you can make money moves and whatnot. She's in her early 20s. She's still starting out. And that's all I got to say about that. Like I said, and I'm not an advocate of weed smoking anyways. But I always say, if you're gonna be in that mindset, at least be on the money making side of things. Don't always be the freaking consumer, because that's where people end up becoming the losers a lot of times, when you only consume and you don't produce. So. Sad to say that, but I just had to get my 2 cents in and go from there. All right. So do the great three free things, family. Like, share, and subscribe. Have a great day. And as I always say, make money moves or you're going to live broke like a fool. Take care.